A century ago, the ground on which you are standing was part of a large industrial complex called the Corning Glassworks. The tower in front of you, known as the Tube Tower or Little Joe Tower, is one of the few remaining artifacts of the factory buildings, furnaces, and smokestacks that once covered over 12 square blocks along the Chemung River. There are lots of theories, but no one knows for sure how Little Joe Tower got its name. While today Little Joe is a landmark, the tower actually shrouds remnants of a machine that revolutionized the mass production of precision glass tubing used for thermometers. Prior to towers like Little Joe, glass tubing was drawn out by hand, horizontally. During a trip to England, Arthur Houghton, the grandson of Corning Glassworks founder Amory Houghton, learned about a new process that drew out glass vertically and took advantage of gravity to make longer and more consistent tubing. Upon returning to Corning in 1897, Houghton patented a variation of this process. When Little Joe was in operation, the tower was physically connected to one of the large factory furnace buildings. On the building's second floor, a team of gaffers gathered a football-sized gather of clear glass on the end of a blowpipe. A bubble was blown into the glass, which eventually becomes the hollow part of the tube. After a layer of white glass was applied to one side of the gather, a final layer of clear glass was added to the entire gather. This was then shaped into a triangular loaf, ready to be stretched. The hot glass and blowpipe were quickly wheeled on a cart into the tower, along with a heated metal plate. Once in the tower, the operator locked the plate into the floor, attached the blowpipe to a carriage mounted on a vertical track, and adhered the glass to the metal plate. To start the draw, the operator used a motor-controlled pulley system to slowly pull the blowpipe carriage to the top of the 18-story tower, while using calipers, compressed air, and motor speed to monitor and control the diameter of the glass tube. Once fully stretched, the 180-foot triangular tube of glass quickly cooled and was slowly lowered and broken into 6-foot lengths. The resulting tubing had one white side and a hollow core 1/12 the thickness of a human hair. The tubing was now ready to be tested, sorted, and sold to a variety of thermometer makers. Tubing from the Little Joe Tower helped transform home healthcare with the first affordable mass-produced home medical thermometers. Other products included the Motometer thermometer for automobiles, as well as a range of thermometers for technical and commercial applications. By the mid-20th century, more efficient continuous tube drawing technologies began to emerge. Little Joe was reduced to the production of specialty glass tubing. Production within Little Joe Tower officially stopped in 1973. Over the following decades, Corning Incorporated continued to invest heavily in research, development, and technology, closing the downtown factories and eventually replacing them in 1991 with the Black Glass World Headquarters building and public green space. Fully restored in 2015, Little Joe Tower stands proudly as a community monument, preserving the memory of one chapter in Corning's long history of innovation.